Today I'm going to show you how to work with the standards for the teaching profession on my portfolio using the smart evidence functionality, meaning that the competency frameworks and the standards are already all set up for you, and all you need to do is align your portfolio to them. In order to create the portfolio, you go to your portfolio as usual to the pages and collections. And I've already set up a portfolio for us to use. Namely, that one contains three pages. And on the portfolio, you can have your regular portfolio evidence that you like to have there, including images and journal entries and the like. Now, the first thing we will need to do is attach the standards to that portfolio, and you do that by going to the collections edit screen and selecting the smart evidence framework. If your school does, or if you do not see the smart evidence framework selector on your collection settings page, then please speak with your institution administrator, because then that just means that the functionality has not been enabled for your school. But that is something that they can do very easily in the institution settings. Now, in this case, you should all see three frameworks, namely first the Tireo Māori one, then a framework that contains both Tireo Māori and English, and then the English framework. Let's choose the one that contains both. And once I've selected that, I can save that information. And now when I go to my collection for the appraisal, the first page that I see is the standards page. So that I do already have the standards that make that, sorry, the standards that make up the framework, the standards for the teaching profession on the left hand side. And they are there in both Tireo and also in English, just a little bit further down. In this case, because I selected the Māori and English one. And then my three portfolio pages that are already contained in this portfolio are immediately linked into this page so that I can align them with my standards. At the top, you have the description of the standard and general information that you also find on the Education Council website. Now, in order to align my portfolio with the standards, what I always do, in this case, what I always need to do is align a portfolio page with a particular standard. And in order to do so, you can always preview these standard indicators in order to make sure that you've selected the correct ones. And then click the little round circle in order for an annotation window to come up. In that window, you can then say why you think this particular portfolio page that you've selected fits the standard for the treaty. If you scroll further down, you again see the indicators mentioned so that you can make sure to refer back to them, and therefore can read them again and see what is expected of you in there. And then in the annotation field itself, you can provide your reasoning why you think it needs to go with the this particular portfolio page is aligned with the standards. And you can write in English, or you can also write in Tireo Māori. Once you've saved that annotation, the icon changes and is now ready for assessment. So now that is an indicator for the appraiser that the content on that portfolio page can be read with reference to this particular standard. And you can go through your entire portfolio in a similar fashion, always by clicking on the little icon and then making your meta-reflection about the standard, so really linking the content on a page to the standard. The important thing here is to mention that you always link an entire page to a standard, or if you want to link certain learning evidence only that is on the page, then you would need to specify that more clearly and more separately, because at the moment you can only link a page to a standard and not individual learning evidence to a standard. That might be something that is being developed in the future of Mahara. So now we've got we've made two alignments, and now is the point where an assessor comes in or an appraiser. So in order to do that, I will first need to give them access to this collection. And that has already been done. In this case, I have the administrator here. And I can change that access at any point in time if I like. In my case, I can log in as the appraiser. And so I'm just switching to that view. And so I'm now logged in as a different person and see the same portfolio that that I have just edited, but the icons are slightly different on the Smart Evidence Overview page. So I cannot make an annotation now as appraiser. I can only verify the evidence and see if I agree with the alignment or not. Of course, I can first review the portfolio, review the evidence that is on there before I make my assessment. And so once I have done that, I can come back here to this overview page, because on here you see very quickly which standards have already been aligned and which ones are still outstanding. You can also do the assessment directly from the portfolio page. Typically, I find it a bit easier doing it from this overview page here on the Smart Evidence page itself, because then I have the overview and also see the descriptors there very easily again. So now in this case, I've taken the look at the Teaching Team Collaboration portfolio page and want to look at the reflection why this portfolio page is now aligned with the Trinity standard. I can read the annotation, and then I can also give feedback and I can make my assessment. And in the assessment, there are three possibilities, namely doesn't meet the standard, partially meets the standard, or meets the standard. And I can select the most appropriate one there and also leave feedback, especially if there is still some more work to be done. If I like, I can make the feedback private so that only the SSC can see it. Place my feedback and then I can also place my assessment. And once I've placed my assessment, the icon changes again so that I can see directly if I go in as me again, who is being assessed. If I refresh the page, the icon is changed as well, and I can see directly what the assessment was, either by going to the page itself or clicking the icon, and then reading the feedback that I have received. And that's how I can go through my entire portfolio and the standards in order to align them to the standards for the teaching profession. In this case, we have set up the standards so that there's an external appraisal possible, meaning that there's an appraisee and an appraiser. But it were also possible that the standards are being set up so that self-appraisal is possible. And that would then mean that I myself can change the icon here and say whether I think I've already achieved the standards or whether I still need to do some work. If you have any questions regarding that functionality and how it is being used on my portfolio, please do get in touch by sending an email to support@myportfolio.school.nz or post in the support forums in the My Portfolio discussions group.